All right, guys, I'm glad to have you back. What we have going on today is the punch up list. We are approaching the end of the job and we have the punch out list. Usually around about that time, when the job begins to come to an end, you have a list where you go back and put things like supports up and just little small miscellaneous tedious things. And a lot of times when that punch out list start, you know, us welders, we drag up because we know we're going to be put in crazy positions trying to weld things that's next to things, that's next to things, that's under things, and existing things. I don't want to sound confusing to you guys, so I'm going to explain what I'm talking about. Like, for an example, this support right here. Okay, as you can see, it's next to the wall. So you have to weld this pipe to the support. And guess what? You have to get behind it also. This support right here is already up. So that's what you call an existing part. So that's what the punch list consists of. Some things such as this here. We had to actually add this shoe onto this pipe. And of course I had to get behind here to weld this side also. So things like that. And it can also get a little more, well, it could also get a lot more difficult. Not saying this, that weld right there is the most difficult weld, but you know, you have things like that. You might have to go back and there might be a revision on a piece of pipe and it might not be a good position and got insulation all over the place and just a bunch of BS you don't want to deal with. But this is the nature of the business and it is what it is. You can either make the choice to leave or stay. And in my case, I'm going to stay. I'm going to stay. Continue to make that money. It's not the... To me, welding is welding, right? So, it is what it is. Just got to take your time, take a deep breath, relax, and get the punch out list done. And for those of you guys who are just entering into the field, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. You're going to have an opportunity to do a punch out list if you stay on a project until the end. So, that's what I got going on this morning. And also, it's like 19 degrees outside. That don't add to the, you know, that don't add to the easiness of this whole ordeal. But, you know, it's all good. And again, I'm just showing you guys this so you can have an idea what to expect towards the end of a project. Again, this is the punch out list. As you can see, the position I'm in, I'm laying on my back once again. And I'm gonna show you what we're working on. Okay, that right there is a valve that should have been put in, but it was missed by one of the fitters who was working on this line at one point in time. So, because I'm here at this point in time, I'm on the punch out list crew. So I have to make that revision along with my fitter. And again, I'm on a scaffold. I'm gonna show you. I don't know if you can see. Yeah. and it's me, so I gotta cram in under here and make that weld. It's just a socket weld, or a fillet weld rather, on a flange. So, I'm gonna be showing you guys different things that's on this punch out list, so you guys can get a good look at what you have to expect when you get into the field and approach the end of a job. Like I said, Triple C, cool, calm, and collected. Just gotta take it easy. There go my fitter. And we're gonna preheat this right here. This is a P22. And I'll see you guys in a minute. And sometimes on a punch out list, you left to do welds without a scaffold. You know, it could seem like it's a little bit unsafe. You gotta look out for yourself, because everybody wants the job done. It's rush, 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 rush. So I'm making this weld right here, this 6-inch weld. As you can see, no scaffold. But for the most part, I'm looking out for myself. So this is what you can expect on a punch out list. Yeah, so this is a prime example of what I was explaining. Some of these positions is like ridiculous. Okay, so what I got going on, we actually trying to put this support up right here. What you see is here. That supports this 6-inch carbon steel pipe here. It was supposed to already have been actually welded up months ago. But again, because this is punch out time, this is where you guys, like myself, will go back and again do things like this here. But as you can see, well, you're getting ready to see as I show you. Right beside this beam, I'm about, I guess, one story in the air. And the position I got a weld in, the beam is right here. Right. There you go. Right against that pillar. But I'm right here. On the other side. As you can see. See if I can get a good shot. There you go. I'm on the other side of the beam. Cable tray. Me, myself, have to weld around the corner. I'm sticking my head around this corner like this right here. It's a very tight spot. Cramped up, chest compressed. So these are the things you guys have to look forward to on a punch out. We'll see how I can get myself out of this fine mess. But not before I weld this beam out. It's just the nature of the beast. Punch out time, baby. Punch out time. Today I'm a fitter. I should be wearing the face shield, but
No excuse. Safety first.
Yeah, so today I'll be making these Schedule 80 12-inch butt welds. As you can see, the position, you guys gonna have to get used to squeezing in a tight position, like I always mention in a lot of the videos. So this would actually be a tight position. As far as getting to that butt weld. Let me see if I can get a better shot. You see that right there? See how much space you got? You got the cable tray right here. Of course, you got the scaffold poles. Not that bad, but again, if you're not used to getting into tight spots, that could give you a little bit of an issue. That's why you gotta practice. Whenever you're inside the weld booth, one of the things you wanna do is practice doing it the hard way. Okay, a lot of times you see guys, when it comes to stick welding, they got that shotgun pose. There's nothing wrong with that if that's what you wanna do. But a lot of times you got to practice not posing, a freehand. Okay, what I mean by freehand, I guess you would, let's see, I'll give you an example here in a little bit. But yeah, that's what I got going on today, and it's not that bad, not that bad at all. And this will be an x-ray weld. When it comes to making x-ray welds, it's not necessarily the scariest thing like people say. You know, whenever you hear you got an x-ray weld and you get all nervous and shaky and, you know, thinking it's the end of the world. And listen, just don't stick your tungsten to the best of your ability. And if you do stick your tungsten, go back and grind that spot. Make sure you break down the walls. Okay. If you having an issue with suck back, you have a tolerance. You know, some specs you would read and they would tell you not to have over a 16th suck back, or they would say you can't have no more than a 16th suck back, in other words. And you got some projects it's a little bit more intolerance. You know, they'll tolerate a little bit more suck back than, you know, some other projects. Different projects, they got different specifications on pipe, different codes they go by. But it's not that big of a deal. Just, you want to have a sharp tungsten, of course, because the sharper your tungsten, the better you'll be able to place that molted puddle. Okay, wherever you point that tungsten, that's where the filler metal is going to go at. If it's dull, just imagine yourself writing or trying to draw a picture with a dull pencil. You tell me how that's gonna come out. Yeah, basically the same thing. Same thing with welding with a dull tungsten. Let's see what else. What else? What else can I talk to you about? Besides that, wait till my fitter fly that piece up that we got to put in place, and I'll have the QC buy off the fit. And what I mean by buy off the fit, for some of you guys who may not understand what I'm talking about, whenever you get ready to make a pipe weld, okay, and your two pipes are in position against each other, your gap is right, then a QC has to come up and he have to actually look at the fit. He might take out his gauges and make sure the high-low is not over tolerance. Make sure everything's good and ready to make a solid, decent weld. And after he sign off on the fit up,
You put your few tacks in, you like it, it's all yours. It's usually after the third tack. After you tack it three times, that's it. It's yours anyway. But you'll do fine. No worries. Just jump out there and get it done. You gotta be the first one. And that'll be the second one, right there where that cap's welded to that little puck piece sticking out of that tank. Sing a song for the broken heart.
Backup hood.
What was wrong with that? Why was you using that?
My batteries went out.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. The little flat batteries.
Yeah.
Flat battery,
like
2032
or something?
3202. 3202. Yeah, something like that. You still got yours?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Sam gave me his old
thing
about
take
blades out of it, put it in
mine. Yeah. Hell yeah.
Finish both these today?
Huh?
You
think
you finished both these
today? I don't
know. Yeah.
Probably not.
Yeah, Frank's on fucking Ralph's ass about getting this shit done. So he said if you can gain any bit by helping out.
Oh no, there's nothing you can do.
That's good.
But I'm just trying. I'm gonna roll as fast as I can though. All right.
And that heat up. He said it's good.
Yeah.
And that heat up.
I am. 150. Nah, I'm gonna try to. Bitches. We'll be right back.
Tight spot. It's all good though. Tight spots, you gotta keep yourself in shape. Well, spitting spots like this might not work out for you. You gotta exercise, keep yourself in shape, eat healthy. Take care of your body, or else your body ain't gonna be able to take care of you. You gotta keep making that money, baby. Let's go. P22. P22. All day, baby. And sometimes you find yourself in the strangest places. Just part of the job. Punch out time, baby. Somebody help me out here? Anybody? I guess this is just the conditions of the battle. Punch out time. What? It's punch out time.
It's checkout time.
Gotta go.
Yeah, baby. It's checkout time. Gotta go, nigga. Gotta go.
Y'all know what time.
Come on, man. Get y'all bags, man. Call that bell, motherfucker. Time to get a nigga shit. Cause we out this motherfucker.